Chapter 25, Diana's Death and Service. At the beginning of September 1997, I returned to San Francisco from 2 weeks in Japan, and just as before, I was welcomed back to the U.S. with news of more untimely death. During my last visit to Japan in March of the same year, the members of Heaven's Gate committed mass suicide in San Diego. See Section 1, Chapter 16, A Mistaken Gate. During this visit, Princess Diana was killed in a violent car accident, and Mother Teresa died of a long-term illness. Seeing the pattern, a friend of mine joked that I should stay in San Francisco more often to prevent such events. Of course, these deaths have nothing to do with my travels, but their aftershocks were felt by many. Not missing a step, I gave a lecture at the San Francisco Whole Life Expo on the day of my return. Surprisingly, nearly 50 people came, and while few of them knew my work, everyone seemed receptive and eager for a deeper message. At the end, a lady came up to the stage and asked me if I thought Princess Di was a wanderer. After a short reflection, I said, yes, she probably was. If so, then perhaps there is more to her death than meets the eye. From seeing her photos, Diana seemed to have a kind of radiance, and apparently she truly cared about the people around her. She certainly had a good heart and was somewhat out of step with the complex demands of her royal role. Charles, too, seems somewhat innocent, and like fourth-density E.T. souls, appears somewhat kindly, but not quite so quick on the ball, expressing love without a comparable degree of wisdom, perhaps. On the other hand, Princess Diana may have been a somewhat older wanderer with a bit more wisdom than her somewhat clumsy royal ex. That Diana may have been a wanderer is of itself not particularly important, since there are many E.T. souls in the public eye, almost all of whom are probably unaware of their cosmic roots. What is important, however, is how it may have played a part in her tragic death, which means that her accident may not have been an accident at all. When thinking about anyone's passing over, we need to consider three options. Death may be, one, a needed experience for karmic balance, soul learning, or simply the timely end of incarnation. Two, the result of genuine non-planned accident, which is sometimes called planetary karma. Or three, an expression of sacrifice and world service coming from a somewhat more evolved soul. In my view, Lady Diana did not have much or such heavy karmic baggage, and option number one doesn't seem to fit too well. Was her death then merely accidental? If she was indeed a wanderer, then the answer is probably no. In that case, it was certainly planned by higher self with her agreement. Like the murder of John Lennon, another likely wanderer, the death of Diana has been the catalyst for tremendous outpouring of love and sympathy. I know two friends who stayed up all night watching the broadcast of her funeral, which made international headlines. While Diana apparently did much good during her lifetime, she seems to have done even more after her passing, helping all those who in some way identified with her purity under duress, which is a form of sacrifice, to be sure, to open their own hearts a little bit further. Self-offering is the way of all wanderers and servers, and as Ra noted, love and light go where they are needed. Perhaps at a higher level, Lady Diana recognized the love that was latent in the millions who watched her from afar. Perhaps she knew that the stimulus of an apparent tragic early death was a potent way to help bring it forth. If so, then we really should not grieve or mourn or feel sorry for her. Rather, we can appreciate the power and beauty of her final act of service to the whole world. In the next chapter, we're going to change gears and explore some of the basic principles of self-healing, then look at their application to daily life.